you know.
Yep. Okay, and we're recording. So Lindsay, take it away.
Perfect. Hi, everyone. Welcome to today's session. I am so delighted that you can join me as I talk about Ontario Extend, an open program to enhance digital fluency for educators. Extend is a timely and relevant professional learning program for which we have seen participation increase by over 300% just this year when compared to the same period from last year. My name is Lindsay, as Christina mentioned, Lindsay Woodside, and I work as a digital learning associate who leads the Ontario Extend Initiative. And my co-presenter, Lena Patterson, who is the Senior Director of Programs and Stakeholder Relations, was to join me today, but she sends her regrets due to a scheduling conflict with a panel session that she's currently on. So I'm flying solo, but rest assured, you are in capable hands. Although we meet in a virtual platform today, I would like to begin by acknowledging the Indigenous peoples of all the lands that we are on today, and personally, the traditional lands of the Neutral, Anishinaabe, and Haudenosaunee peoples, where I join you today. As a settler, I'm grateful to live and work on this land. Please join me in acknowledging our shared responsibility to improve understanding of local Indigenous peoples and cultures. So during today's session, I'm going to be presenting on the following pieces. So I'll start off here momentarily by providing a brief introduction into eCampus Ontario. So who are we and what do we do? I'll move into introducing the Ontario Extend program. I'll provide a high-level overview of some of the main nuts and bolts of the Ontario Extend program. I'll then move into providing you with some data and testimonials in Extend in Action, which illustrate program uptake and value since it commenced, and in particular, highlight for you the increased engagement and uptake, which I just spoke about, that we have noted this year. I'll then move into sharing with you an exciting recent global program adoption case study. And provide you with some contact details if you're interested in adopting and customizing this program for your own context. And we'll round off the session today, hopefully providing a few minutes for question and answer. So again, as Christina mentioned there at the beginning, she has kindly agreed to drop some links to various websites and videos into the chat for me that I will be referencing. I just want to note that you can access all of these in OEG Connect on the session presentation page, along with this slide deck. So you may or may not be aware, but eCampus Ontario is a Canadian nonprofit government-funded consortium, and our members are all of the 46 publicly assisted institutions in the province of Ontario. So that consists of 24 colleges and 21 universities, and we are all part of the same ecosystem. Our headquarters are located in Toronto, Ontario, and we are the Center of Excellence in Online and Tech-Enabled Learning for all publicly assisted colleges and universities, as I mentioned. And this week, just to note, we are also the hosts of the Eastern time zone for OE Global as well. So just give a quick shout out to that. So moving along here, we work in a space of digital fluency education with open principles and values throughout. One of the ways in which we support Ontario educators, and Christina's just going to drop the first link into the chat there, is through the Ontario Extend program. The Ontario Extend program is a suite of professional learning resources that launched back in 2017. And this has really been a pivotal time for Extend. And the importance of this program has been in its value as a holistic baseline for digital skills. Moving into a few more of the nuts and bolts of the program. So as I mentioned, launched in 2017, the program consists of 6 modules, which take on average about 4 to 6 hours each to complete. And upon the successful completion of each of the modules, participants are able to apply for a digital open badge, which demonstrates skills achievement for that particular module. And when all six modules are collected, I'm going to show you a graphic here in a moment. When all six badges are collected, participants can apply or are automatically awarded, rather, the Empowered Educator Milestone Badge. The program is self-directed, self-paced, and/or it can be collaborative. It's been offered through cohort-style framework by many of our teaching and learning centers across the province. The program is openly licensed. It's available in both English and French. And we've seen a range of participants in terms of the profile of an Ontario Extend participant. So anyone that wants to build up digital skills for teaching and learning, so whether that be an instructional designer, instructional technologist, librarian, you know, frontline educator, grad student, the list goes on. So here's a graphic here which helps illustrate the program. So the program has foundations and origins in Simon Bates's model for the 21st century educator. And I'll just give you a quick sort of Coles Notes version here of the program modules. So up on the top left there is the Teacher for Learning module. This module is focused on SMART principles for effective teaching and sort of roots one in their pedagogy. Below that on the left-hand side is our Curator module. This module is a really nice low-stakes entry point to learning about open education resources, Creative Commons and copyright, and how to vet open education resources. Below that on the left, the technologist module is focused on leveraging a design thinking approach to solving learner challenges. We toggle over to the right, the collaborator module is focused on building up professional learning networks across and between discipline areas. Below that, one of my all-time favorite modules of really learn by doing and getting your hands dirty and has been leveraged extensively this year has been the experimenter module. And this module is focused on leveraging all of the open technologies that the modules reference in terms of experimenting with technology in your classroom. And then below that is the scholar module on the bottom right. And this module is a reflective module that encourages one to focus and reflect on the scholarship of teaching and learning. We're often asked, you know, where do I start? We often recommend starting with the Teacher for Learning module as it grounds one in the pedagogy first before sort of, embarking into the technology pieces. But after the Teacher for Learning module, the great thing about this program is it's sort of a choose your own adventure. And so these modules meet you where you are. And so you pick with what you start with next after the Teacher for Learning module. And again, you can see there in the middle, when you achieve all six of those digital badges, which can be shared on, you know, LinkedIn and social media profiles, you're automatically awarded that Empowered Educator badge there in the middle. Just pausing there for any questions, Christina, if any questions have come up in the chat yet.
Nothing or yet.
Issues? Okay, perfect. Okay. Sorry, okay, perfect. So let's move on to exploring Extend in action. So I'm gonna provide you with some data and testimonials which help illustrate program engagement and uptake. And I'm gonna share with you the global adoption of the program in New Zealand, as I mentioned at the beginning. So how are our own Ontario institutions leveraging Extend? We recently set out to better understand how Extend was being used at our provincial institutions and how it was being customized and adopted. And this was done earlier this year. And Christina's just going to drop a link into the chat there for the Ontario Extend Practice in Research Practice report. This report, again, which was published on our website earlier this year, was focused on finding out the ways in which the modules and resources are being used by colleges and universities in Ontario. This was accomplished through a survey that was distributed and some follow-up interviews. And the findings were interesting. We determined at the time that 10 institutions reported their use of these materials for course curriculum, professional learning opportunities, and professional learning recognition. Institutions cited, didn't go to the next screen, there we go. Institutions cited materials being used as supplemental resources in newsletters for faculty onboarding that complemented existing educator programming and recognizing one's involvement in professional development activities. One of the greatest values of undertaking this report was being able to confirm that Extend was being customized to the local context of institutions, which was really great to see. I'm happy to report that at the beginning of 2020, as I just mentioned, we noted uptake from 10 of our institutions. I'm now happy to report that that is now at 20. So we've seen an additional 10 institutions adopt and customize this program just in the last 10 months since the beginning of the year. So uptake to date, what does that look like? So 900 plus educators have participated in the program since its inception back in late 2017. And we've issued 450 digital badges. So those badges that I showed you there on the previous screen. And we have 40 empowered educators across the province. You might be looking at those numbers and going, I wonder why there's so many participants, but not as many badges. And that's really due to the flexibility of the program. Again, you can start, stop, or pause your learning journey whenever you like. So we've seen many participants who have come in and dabbled in the program and are likely continuing or planning to continue to extend their journey and continue on the journey, and they can come back to it at their own leisure. Just to share a quick testimonial with you, you can see there on the screen. So thanks to Ontario Extend, this was really powerful. I no longer avoid technology-based learning in my courses. I was able to complete all 6 modules at my own pace and earn my Empowered Educator badge. Ontario Extend equals confidence. And that was from Connie. She just became an Empowered Educator a month ago here in Ontario from Fanshawe College. All right, so let's now take a closer look at some more recent uptake by way of some data visualization. So we can see here on the left, the graph shows program site visitation through page views, which you can see has been on a steady incline since post-secondary institutions closed in Ontario back in March 2020, as evidenced by that darker top purple line, when compared to the same period in 2019, as seen in the lighter purple line there on the bottom. So again, that's directly as a result of schools closing and the program importance on a steady incline. In addition to the increased site traffic has also been supported by the successful piloting in Ontario of a series of facilitated deliveries of this program at institutions since April 2020. And so what I mean by that is the increase is twofold. It's likely due to post-secondary education's closing, and then a facilitated approach that we've used since April 2020 in assisting teaching and learning centers across the province with the deployment of various Ontario Extend modules. Over to the world map on the right-hand side, site visitation since January 2020 has been quite geographically dispersed outside of Canada, obviously represented there in the dark purple. This data speaks to the importance of this program, as I mentioned before, in its value as a holistic baseline for digital skills, but also confirms that educators are seeking this type of professional development and learning. If you look closely to the map on the right, you'll note that New Zealand is shaded in light purple. And I'm really excited to share with you how Extend ended up extending itself, pun intended, to the opposite side of the world from Canada. So let's take a look at our case study. Okay, so back in late 2019, our friends at Otago Polytechnic, which is a public tertiary education institution in New Zealand, reached out to us after hearing about Extend at an international open symposium with the intent to customize the Extend program resources to pilot for their educators to enable and empower them to evidence and develop their practice before rolling it out nationally across other polytechnics in New Zealand and internationally via the OERU network. and partner institutions throughout the developing world. So in early 2020, we connected with Claire Good, who is a learning and teaching specialist at Otago Polytechnic. And she was collaborating with the New Zealand Center for Open Education Practice, which is also supported by Wayne McIntosh, director of OER Foundation, of the OER Foundation, to make this a possibility. So it's important here, as you're sort of looking at the screen and seeing the steps that Otago Polytechnic undertook to make this a reality, it's important to note that Otago did most of the heavy lifting while we were cheerleading them on. So they kept to the spirit of the open license of the program, but the content was developed by them in their Wiki Educator or in Wiki Educator and published in WordPress, thus, you know, openly available to others for adaptation and for scaling. They used the Moodle, OER Moodle, as a launch pad for learners, and Claire amended some of the language in the modules so that they were appropriate to geographical and cultural references. You can see there on the right-hand side on the graphic with the badges, she also adapted the badges to give them a bit of a different look and feel for the New Zealand context. So they were able to roll out the program through a pilot and they saw over 25 educators participate in that pilot. Nine of them received badges. And through a series of progress and final updates that they shared with us, they noted that they did intend to move to roll out the program nationally across New Zealand and again through the OERU network. And so that's been really great to hear about their progress and success in adopting and adapting the program to their context for their educators. Again, just to share a quick testimonial, here's Phil Hancock from the Institute of Sport, Exercise and Health at Otago. Overall, I can highly recommend the Extend courses. They're practically applicable, relevant, and simple to work through at your own pace. Again, that theme comes up again, right? At your own pace. I never stop learning with teaching and learning, and this was a great personal development opportunity. So has our program resonated with you today? And perhaps you're an educator or working on behalf of a teaching and learning center and you're interested in customizing this program content for educators at your institution or perhaps embarking on one of the modules yourself. Or if you're looking to learn more about engagement strategies for uptake, I encourage you to reach out to us and connect with me in that regard. And it looks like I have a couple minutes there for questions.
Perfect. You do. You were doing really good in time. Any questions for Lindsay?
I'll drop my email into the chat as well.
Fantastic.
I think there's a question about the potential for Extend for K-12.
Oh, thank you for catching that.
Yeah, that's a great question. So we've been working with the Ontario school system here to provide Extend materials to K-12 educators here in Ontario. And so that work is being done by a committee currently undertaking some of the adaption of those resources. I think they were looking at it in the Ontario context of dropping that into an Ontario wide LMS. But apart from that being Ontario specific, because the program is openly licensed, if you wish to adapt and roll those out for your own context, you're free to do that. Certainly though, if you'd like to connect with me to chat about that further, I'd be happy to. We do know that we have seen appreciation of these program modules at the K-12 level. Of course, they would need some customizing and tweaking because some of the references do reference the post-secondary sector. But again, in the spirit of openness, they are available to adapt and adopt.
Great. That's good to know. I may be following up with you. Any further questions for Lindsay?